Wonder Woman, an Amazonian warrior with a penchant for justice and a mighty weapon, the lasso of truth. The stuff of comic book fantasy or an idea based in reality? Let's uncover the truth. Before creating Wonder Woman, William M. Marston studied law and psychology at Harvard. In 1914, he became fascinated by the idea of monitoring blood pressure to detect lies, leading to his invention of a lie detector. Sorta. Marston's invention, the systolic blood pressure test, looked similar to a blood pressure cuff. Participants were asked a series of questions.
What is your name? Who is the current U.S. president? Did you kill the milkman?
If the suspect's blood pressure spiked,
I did not.
It suggested a conspicuous reaction provoked by a lie. As war raged overseas, a fear of foreign agents spread rapidly, and Marston heralded his invention to the U.S. government as a surefire way to root out spies. But its reliability quickly came into question. Some government advisors were unconvinced by Marston's research. One prominent reviewer believed the device was too susceptible to emotional responses that had nothing to do with lying, and he said so in a skeptical report. So was that the end of the lie detector? Nope. Enter August Vollmer. Vollmer hoped to reform the aggressive police interrogation tactics of the time with a more scientific way to catch criminals. He tapped John Larsson, an officer with a PhD in physiology, to work on his own device. Just a heads up, we're about to reach the point in history where three different machines, all meant to catch lies, are being discussed, so we'll try to keep it simple. In 1921, Larsson unveiled the cardiopneumocycogram. While Marston's invention solely measured blood pressure, Larsson's new device, made of tubes, gauges, and a long strip of smoked paper, simultaneously recorded bodily changes in pulse, blood pressure, and respiration. And it followed through on Vollmer's goal. It was used in a case that resulted in a murder conviction that same year. Reporters celebrated the invention, nicknaming it the Lie Detector, a moniker that Larsson would grow to detest. In 1923, Larsson joined forces with Leonard Keeler,
a high school student and amateur magician,
yes, really, to fine-tune the device's mechanics. Larsson later learned that his invention was far from infallible. A suspect had given a false confession to avoid disclosing her personal history of sexual abuse. To Larsson, his invention no longer represented a reliable scientific method, and instead became another tool for manipulation and coercion. He later quit the police force and pursued medical school. At the time, Larsson wasn't the only one who took issue with the criminal justice system using machines to suss out the truth. That same year, a federal court created a new standard by which scientific evidence could be presented in a criminal trial. Marston's original creation from 1915 was deemed an invalid form of evidence because it had not yet gained general acceptance in the field.
Larsson's assistant, Keeler, however, patented an updated device in 1931, the Keeler polygraph.
He sold it to the FBI and positioned himself as its primary expert witness in multiple court cases. During the Cold War, it was used in an attempt to uncover espionage. Keeler himself even traveled to an atomic bomb plant with his polygraph to unmask potential spies. Ultimately, the device, which many federal employees found grueling to experience, never caught a major communist enemy agent.
In fact, Aldrich Ames, a CIA case officer who worked as a Russian spy for almost a decade,
successfully passed two polygraph tests prior to his eventual arrest in 1994. Generally, the machine's results lacked reliability. Regardless, throughout the next few decades, the federal government heavily relied on polygraphs for employee screenings and criminal investigations, conducting around 1 million exams annually between 1981 and 1988. Mounting criticism moved Congress to introduce greater oversight, leading to a law that prohibited most private employers from mandating polygraph tests for workers and job applicants. However, the act does not cover federal, state, and local government agencies, where it is still heavily in use. John Larsson lived out his life with huge regrets.
calling his creation a Frankenstein's monster, which I have spent over 40 years in combating. His invention, for better or worse, still sparks interest today. The device is now a part of the collection at the Smithsonian's National Museum of American History, where two conservation labs and seven conservators worked painstakingly over the course of 5 years to restore it. The museum initially received Larsson's machine from the Berkeley Police Department in the 1970s, though some components were missing. Conservators created replicas of those lost elements to put the device back to how it would have operated in its heyday. The device also arrived with a roll of paper, with the results of three previous tests from the police department. Conservators produced photographic facsimiles of these papers, which can also be seen on display at the museum. While the allure of catching someone in a lie is irresistible, the path to uncovering the truth is anything but simple. Maybe, just maybe, we should leave the truth-seeking in Wonder Woman's capable hands. Be sure to check out more exciting Smithsonian objects on another episode of National Treasure.